Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you what is inside a VPAX file. First of all, the VPAX file is what you can obtain, for example in RStudio, using the Export Matrix button. I exported the information of the VertiPaq Analyzer for a model in a file called VPAX. Now, we have seen in other videos that this file contains all the information about your model in terms of distribution of the data in the tables, in the columns, and description of the data model. But this file doesn't contain any data of your model. Now, before sending this file by email to someone that can help you from a technical perspective, you may want to make sure you're not disclosing any sensitive data. And I want to show you how to explore the content of this file. This is a zip file. So basically what we can do to explore its content is creating a copy of the file and renaming this file into a zip file. So I do this operation here, and once I have a zip file, the file can be expanded in my file system, and this is what I'm going to do using extract all. This way I have in a single folder, that now will have the name Contoso, all the files that are included in the VPAX file. These are text files that I can open with an editor, and this way I can make sure I'm not disclosing any sensitive data. So let's take a look at these files one by one. First of all, there is a very small file that you can open with an editor. I'm using Notepad, but of course you can use a more advanced editor for reading, in this case, an XML file, which is just a description of the format of the content of this folder. So usually this is not anything you should be concerned about. The second file I'm going to open is one of these files. So I will start with the DAX model, but you see I have DAX model, DAX VPA view, and model. So DAX model is a JSON file, which is a particular representation in a text file that provides me information about my data model. What is here? If you scroll along this file, you will see that we have a description of the table, a description of the columns, with information about the data model itself. Now, this file also contains additional information, like, for example, the number of rows you have in the table. So it's not just the data model, it contains also some statistics about the data model. But what is important, because it's better to know what we are exporting, we not only have all the tables and all the columns, we have also the measures. So the definition of the measures is part of the model. In case you are concerned about disclosing the definition of the measure, pay attention because this is part of the data that you are exporting. However, we don't have any data of the model. We don't have any row contained in the tables. We just have a description, the name of the table, the name of the column, and the number of rows in the table, the number of unique values in each column, the size in memory, the description of the measure, the definition of the measure, not the data that we have in the model. We can make sure that this is true also for the other files. For example, if I open this DAX VPA view file, if I open this file with Notepad, this is another JSON file that has a simplified version of the information that you have seen in the other JSON file, but basically we repeated the same information, and also in this case we have the definition of the measures included here. It is just a different internal format to simplify what other tools can do using this output. Finally, we have a third file called modem.bim file. So this is exactly the model that you will have, for example, in Visual Studio if you use analysis services. And this is a description of the data model of the file that is using the internal representation of TOM, which is the library used to program analysis services. Once again, this contains definition of tables, definition of columns. In this case, this particular file doesn't have any statistics about the distribution of the data, but once again, I have here the definition of the measures. I'm showing the definition of the measure because in my experience is what many people are more concerned about. They say, no, we don't want to disclose the measures. Well, be aware that we are disclosing the measures to anyone who will receive this file. So in case you don't want to disclose this information, as of today, you can create a copy of the file, remove all the measures, and then export the file without any measure. As of today, this is the only way. But remember, you also have DAX code for calculated columns and definition of the role-based security. All these DAX expressions could be in this file. Pay attention that this could be here too. But if this is not a concern, you can make sure that you are not disclosing any sensitive data like the customer name, patient name if you are in healthcare. And once you validate that, you can safely send this VPAX file to someone else that can help you investigating in a technical problem. Enjoy DAX!